हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9th, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ चैप्टर सेल दैट इज द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ, आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज टिश्यू। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट ऑल द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे आर मेड अप ऑफ सो मेनी सिस्टम्स इन देयर बॉडी एंड इन देयर बॉडी सो मेनी सिस्टम्स आर मेड अप ऑफ सो मेनी ऑर्गन्स and organs are made up of different types of the tissues and all the tissues are made up of the different types of the cells. So you can understand that the tissue like this, this is the living body made up of systems made up of organs and organs made up of tissues and tissues made up of cells. So that is why the cells are called the structural and functional unit of the living organism. Dear student, in this series of the different structural organization of a living organism, we are here. We have studied this and we are here at the study of the tissue. Now let us explain the tissue. Dear student, tissue can be defined as the structural, the similar the group of cells, those are similar in their structure and functions are called tissue. So there are different types of the cells, as you have studied about the different shape of the cells, different size of the cells, different groups of the cells. Now we study here about the different groups, and these different groups are specified for the specific functions. So now let it continue. These groups are responsible for functions up to the mark, means they have to perform absolutely, they have to perform in high quantity, they have to perform accurately. That is why they have been grouped together. So if, for example, take the example of the secretion different secretions of by the cells, like the digestive enzyme, take the example of the digestive enzyme. So dear student, in the pancreas there are the group of the cells which secrete trypsin, there are the group of the cells which secrete hydrochloric acid in the stomach. So these are the groups which perform the specific function, that is the hydrochloric acid secretion, and they have to maintain the level of the amount of the hydrochloric acid. That is why they have been grouped together. Single cell cannot perform all those functions, the larger amount of the secretion. That is why they have been grouped. So there is a need of the tissue in the living organism that you are looking here. My dear student, as far as the study of the tissue is concerned, you have to classify it into two parts. So let us see how you can classify it. They can be classified into the plant tissue, plants tissue, and second, animal tissue, animals tissue. So these are the classifications that you will study. First of all, plant tissue, then after that you will study the animal tissue. As far as the tissue is concerned, suppose this is the group, suppose this is the cell. So when they get united together, form a specific tissue, that will be called tissue. So this is the example of the tissue. And these are the diagrammatic representation of the tissue in which you can study these things, and somehow you can see this is the intestinal wall, this is the intestinal wall, and this is the specific tissue, and they are responsible for the specific function like secretion, etc. So these are the tissue. This can be classified as the animal tissue. So animal tissue, plant tissue, plant tissue. So dear student, you can understand the group of the cells, the group which are responsible for the performance of the specific function, and they are called the tissue. They have been divided into two groups, plant tissue and animal tissue. My dear students, now you will be able to study here about the plant tissue first of all. So let us start about the plant tissue, and you will see here the plant tissue that is categorized in several categories. The plant tissue that is categorized in the several categories, and what are the categories that we will discuss over here. So let us see this. I am reading this board so that you can understand in a good way, and there will be no any problem of understanding by you people. So dear student, come to the plant tissue. First of all, plant tissue. Plants, tissues, plant tissues. So students, these are the plant tissues which are responsible for the different types of the functions into the plant bodies, like functions of the growth, functions of the conduction of water in the plant body, functions of the conduction of food into the plant body, process of the photosynthesis, etc., etc. So these are the different functions that are performed by the specific groups of the cells. And plant tissue, it can be divided into two groups. Number one, meristematic tissue. Number two, permanent tissue. Permanent tissue. So student, this is the meristematic tissue and permanent tissue that you will study here. First of all, let us start about the meristematic tissue. The meristematic tissues are the growth tissue. Growth tissues, and as far as cells of the meristematic tissues are large nucleus in there, always ready for the division,
always ready, always ready for cell division, always ready for cell division. Let us see what kind of these cells are. These cells are, if you consider these cells, then there will be the large nucleus. And these cells are formed, these cells are found in the different parts of the plant body. For example, if you consider this is the plant, and these are the branches, these are the branches. So therefore, they will be found on the tip, they will be found on the tip, and that is for the growth in height, that is for the growth in height. So these are the apical meristematic tissue, apical meristematic tissue, apical meristematic tissue. They are found on the tip like this, on the tip of the plant body. They will be found on the root tip also, and they will be called as the apical meristematic tissue. Now, my dear students, on the nodes, specific tissues are found of meristematic tissue, and they are called as intercalary meristematic tissues. So this is two types of the meristematic tissue. They are found, and they will be responsible for the more and more branching in the plant body. Furthermore, dear students, some other type of the meristematic tissue, and they are found laterally in the plant body, just beneath the epidermal layer, and they are responsible for the widening of the plant body. Means plant stem will be wider, plant stem will be more wider, and it will grow in width. So growth will be there in width, growth will be there in the branching. So this is the branchings, and this is called lateral meristematic tissue. Lateral meristematic tissue. So students, in this digital video, now you are able to understand the classification of this plant tissue, which is divided into the meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. And meristematic tissues, the structure of the meristematic cells are just like, they are having the large nucleus, they are the growth tissue. Always they are ready for the cell division because they are found on the tip and laterally and at the nodes. So further, these meristematic tissue are divided into three groups. One for height, one is responsible for height, and this is for branching, and this is for widerness. So plant will be more wider, plant stem will be more wider because of the lateral meristematic tissue. Therefore students, this is all about the, and as far as the function of these cells are concerned, when they will be older, then they will be converted into the permanent tissue, simple permanent tissue or complex permanent tissue. They are the initiator of the plant growth, and they will provide the growth in height, in branching and in pile. So these three are the meristematic tissue, 1, 2, and 3. So my dear student, you have to understand this by this little video and notes that is providing to you about this plant tissue. My dear student, now coming on the topic of the permanent tissue. Have a some sort of the permanent tissue, that these are the permanent tissue. Further they will be divided. Have a short look. These permanent tissue are simple and complex. Simple and complex permanent tissue. So my dear students, as the notes have been provided to you, and you will be able to study in detail in the next video about the permanent tissue that will be that will take more time, permanent tissue and complex tissue. Okay students, so I hope this video will be able to provide the knowledge of you about the tissue, definition of the tissue, types of the plant tissues, and what type of the meristematic tissue, that is for the growth. My dear student, take an example. If you take an onion, suppose this is an onion, and this onion is having the roots. So take two onion, and cut one onion root from their tips, and dip it into the water, and take second onion. And that onion, if you dip it into the water, then you will find that the uncut roots, they became longer in the water after 2 or 3 days. This activity proved that there will be the growth in the meristematic tissue, which are found in the root thing also. So in all the growing part, these meristematic tissues are found. My dear students, thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. If you dislike this video, put a dislike on it also. Thank you.